Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you, Chairman. My delegation would like to begin by congratulating you, sir, on your election to the chair of the 17th session of the Conference of States Parties for the Convention on the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons. We are convinced that under your enlightened leadership, our work shall be successful, and you can count on the complete support of the Algerian delegation as you carry out your tasks. My delegation would also like to pay tribute to your predecessor, Ambassador Paul Arkwright of the United Kingdom, for the excellent manner in which he presided over our deliberations at the last session. Likewise, I would like to express my gratitude to the Director General, Ambassador Ahmed Mzumchu, for the efforts that he has tirelessly carried forward at the head of the Secretariat, turning the OPCW into an organization that is both effective and fully aware of the challenges that it faces. My delegation would also like to associate itself with the statements made by the Vice Minister of Foreign Affairs of the Islamic Republic of Iran, Mr. Akhundzadeh, on behalf of the non-aligned countries and China, and Ambassador Sirajuddin Yusuf of Sudan on behalf of the African group. Mr. Chairman, this session of the Conference of States Parties takes place at a time in which we are celebrating the 15th anniversary of the entry into force of the CWC. The convention is a major contribution to strengthening international peace and security. The objective of a world free of chemical weapons is something that requires our constant vigilance and attention. While it's true that we haven't managed to respect the final deadline for the destruction of chemical weapons stockpiles as spelled out in the convention, my delegation remains nonetheless very optimistic that in the near future we shall complete the destruction of these weapons for the betterment of humankind as a whole. Disarmament is one of the fundamental pillars of the convention, and by achieving complete disarmament, we shall significantly reduce the risk of a chemical attack. Mr. Chairman, in order to obtain its objectives, the convention must also become totally universal, and this is why the states' parties must continue with their efforts to lobby those countries that are outside the convention to join as quickly as possible. International cooperation is also an important pillar of the convention. International cooperation should be geared towards strengthening the capacity of states' parties to implement the provisions of the convention. And so international cooperation could have a huge impact on the implementation of the various aspects of the convention. And this is why the convention itself has to be interpreted in its entirety. All of the articles of the convention are mutually strengthening, mutually complementary. And what we have to do is find the ways in which all of the provisions of the convention can really be enforced. And it's only on that premise that the states' parties will be able to work in favor of a world free of chemical weapons in a meaningful way. We are currently preparing the third review conference, and it's important for us to be mindful of that objective that I've just spelled out. In fact, it's this spirit of capacity building that my country recently hosted the first meeting of North African and Sahel countries in the European Union's CBRN Center in Algiers from the 12th and 13th of September 2012. This type of seminar should be encouraged in the future because it's an excellent opportunity for people to exchange experiences, to cooperate, and to create genuine momentum and positive momentum in each of the regions of the world. It's up to the states' parties, with the support of the TS, to be creative in finding new ways to further implement the convention. In so doing, we have to establish clear objectives and make sure that we evaluate what we're doing in an objective manner. Here, I would like to underscore the relevance of the Program for Africa, and I would like to thank the European Union for its financial contribution to this program, as well as to all of the other countries who have chipped in. My delegation is pleased to hear that the European Union is organizing a briefing on this program in parallel with this conference. Mr. Chairman, My delegation would also like to lend its support to the Chair of the Executive Council, Ambassador Baswati Mukherjee of India, for all of the work that she put in to getting us to rethink the working methods of the Council. We believe that the working methods of the EC have to be revised in order to make us more effective in our job. The Algerian delegation requests that this declaration be included as an official document of this conference. Thank you, Chairman.